Power fans, we welcome you into Bill Greehy Arena for our opening night of men's basketball. The St. Mary's Rattlers back in business, taking on A&M Kingsville. David Tovar, Joe Rodriguez back with you. Joe, full disclosure, it's my favorite time of the year. Basketball season, Rattler basketball season at that. The ladies first, they began this week, and now it's the men's turn here inside Bill Greehy Arena. Joe, how excited are you?
I'm tremendously excited, David. I cannot even begin to express this Rattler basketball team coming off of the back-to-back Heartland Conference Championship.
Not one, not two.
And going for your favorite, the three-peat this season, and really coming out strong. The preseason polls seem to agree. The Rattlers ranked second in the Heartland Conference here today, taking on the Texas A&M University Kingsville Javelinas.
Bauer, Benny, Wilson, Matthews, and Ryan Thomas, the starting five in the Rattler white. This is Thomas, that shot no good. Rebounded here by the Javelinas. Number five, Rashard Basie, trying to take it all the way. And you mentioned, Joe, a team who was ranked number two in the preseason polls, a team who has come off two straight national tournament appearances, two Heartland Conference titles. However, we can't even go a minute without mentioning some of the key losses. They've lost their big three, Daryl Taylor, Mo Sundufu, and of course, Kevin Kotzer. That's got a weigh on this team.
And indeed it does, David. But at the same time, they reloaded. And one of those players they reloaded with Ryan Thompson grabbing the rebound there. And another player they reloaded with, Marvin Benny, starting on the court here today as Isaiah Matthews able to grab that board there. These some very impressive players the Rattlers were able to bring in. Ryan Thomas at Central Wyoming College. He is a talking, walking, double-double, average 10-10 every game. Marvin Benny last year, he started every single game. He led the team in assists and steals. And then, of course, I'm most excited to see Marvin Witt come off the bench. He's All-American in junior college, as long as being first-team All-District, obviously, at his old school as well.
And, of course, we can't forget familiar faces. One already at the line, Isaiah Matthews. We talked about it on Talking Rattlers. He looks big, just jacked, really bulked up. He's gonna play a lot of minutes and face a lot of punishment in the post.
Yeah, he really is, and he's well equipped to do so. His freshman year, he had those muscles, but this year he's added way more to his core, in my opinion. And you know that extra weight really helps you out in a long season down there in the post, where you know you're gonna take some beatings. But I think the extra weight that he put on all of it in muscle is really gonna help him out this year as he scores the first point of the game for St. Mary's.
1-0 is the score here. Right around a minute gone by, and then Fred Wilson, who last year was a swing man for the St. Mary's Rattlers, coming off the bench, provided some good defense, also some good corner threes, as that is good, tough layup for number five, Rashard Basie. And Wilson now in a starting role has a huge job here this season early on for the Rattlers.
Yeah, and I really love the Rattlers perimeter defense coming in with this starting lineup. Fred Wilson, and of course we already talked about Benny, two great wing defenders. And we're going to really, the Rattlers, I should say, are going to really need them today going up against Rashard Basie. He was a leading scorer for this Javelina team last year. And last game, he...
And a three!
Last game, as I was saying, basically he scored 22 points. That in the exhibition game against UTPA, the Broncos. So he's primed and ready to go is Basie this season as well.
Oh, and another three answering right back is A&M Kingsville. That's number 12, Thomas Diaz. 5-4 the score here.
Thomas Diaz out of Colombia.
Colombia.
Yes, indeed.
And now, of course, how could we forget Christian Bauer back at point his second straight year starting. Coach Zelsnak last year, some high praise from him, called him one of the best point guards he's ever had in the program. Man. Just a guy who knows how to run the offense and an underrated scorer to boot.
Man, and that was a great finish there by Ryan Thomas, but you have to love the feed from Fred Wilson. He got it immediately, knew what he was going to do with it. And he actually started walking down the court because he knew Thomas was going to finish it, but Thomas drawing the foul and one, so he'll head to the line for the extra.
6-5 the score. Rattlers lead it early on. Thomas's free throw is good. Make it 7-5 here in the early going. Rattlers here known for playing a zone. Now they're playing some man early on. Bauer showing a little bit of pressure early on. Rattlers early on going to use their personnel. Straight man-to-man. Foul here. It'll be on Fred Wilson. It will be called for blocking. That is the first team foul for the St. Mary's Rattlers. Oh.
Basie just able to elevate over the top there and get the finish. I think that's really going to be the matchup at that end. Basie versus Wilson. So 7 apiece, 17 minutes on the clock. It's two teams kind of just feeling each other out in the early going. Here's Wilson. I tried to dish it off to Thomas, but his hands were not up and ready. And that ball popped. Offensive rebound for the Javelinos.
Here's D is going to try it again. Now Ronald Scott bringing it back, controlling him, trying to work against Bauer. Sloppy pass there by Wilson leads to a layup on the other end. That's Rashad Basie, and he has 6 of the Javelinas 9 already. And just like that, Kingsville takes their first lead of this game, 9-7. Here's Benny driving, explosive all the way to the rim. Way to go, Marvin Benny. His first points here inside Bill Grigio Arena. And we heard a lot about him in the offseason, heading toward the preseason. Kid's very athletic, and obviously the coaching staff thinks very highly of him. He's starting already. Here's Wilson. There he is. He's a defensive ace. Driving it off to Benny for the finish, and I think he was blocked by Basie.
Basie already has fingerprints all over this game. 6 points for his Javelinas, and then the huge transition defense there. We're going to have a media timeout here. We'll go on ahead and head there with them as you're watching Rattler basketball on the Rattler Network. And welcome back, Rattler fans. 9-9, all squared away here in the early goings. Some substitutions for the Javelinas. Irvin Hollinger coming into the fray. He'll enter in a game with just about 15:40 left in it. And David, a very exciting time. They tried an alley-oop there, did the Javelinas. The first home game of the year. And as you mentioned, your favorite time of the year. Why should Rattler fans be excited for this team this season?
Well, it's an all-new look, and the Roddy Rattlers almost fooling the Javelinas, and, the joke's on us as that three is buried from deep. The Roddy Rattlers, they have a very good knack for trickery. That one not working, but you asked why so excited. Well, it's a brand-new look. We talked at the opening of this broadcast. The big three are gone as Bauer tries to respond with a three. That one batted out by Matthews and all the way to the hoop. Hard foul there by Bauer.
Good foul.
Good foul, though. And that's Ronald Scott will head to the line. Well, it's a brand new team. And I was going to tell you what I noticed about this team. It's an athletic bunch. I mean, Kevin Kotzer, not exactly the most athletic guy in the world. Neither were Sandufu and Daryl Taylor. They were more of shooters and guys who can create their own jump shot. These guys, right off the bat, you see Marvin Benny getting to the hole, and it looks like he's a guy who can do it at will. Bauer, who's deceptively athletic. Isaiah Matthews, who's an athlete. You want to talk about another athlete? Here comes Joe Monroe.
I was just about to say that.
Yeah. Got Alexander coming in, who has some big shoes to fill as the Rattler post. And Fred Wilson, who's also deceptively athletic in his own right. I'm excited to see this team, a very athletic bunch, that are looking at, and what's more exciting, they're looking for a third straight Hauling Conference title.
Also entering into the game, Justin Alexander. First two games, he's Rattler's leading scorer, average, and also rebounding average. And then you want to talk about athletic Joe Monroe. We saw him at Rattler Madness jump over Efi AK and dunk the ball. It was absolutely incredible.
Yeah, it really was a sight to see. You can see those pictures on our Facebook page, facebook.com/St. Mary's Rattlers. Here's Benny to the hole, and he is fouled. Blocking foul. That will go against the Javelina, so we'll see Benny at the line.
I love the aggression by Benny there, you know, taking on three Javelina players, knowing he was going to take the contact. And Benny also an excellent free throw and three-point shooter. He led his team last year in those departments as well.
As I mentioned, a guy who can, looks like he can get to the hole anytime. He's explosive. He knocks down that free throw. 10-12 the score, and so really an exciting time, and exciting time for Rattler basketball. The ladies off to a great start. They're headed toward Tarleton State manana. But in the St. Mary's Classic this weekend on Friday and Saturday, they were victorious against the Lady Javelinas and Angelo State on Friday and Saturday, respectively. They're just fun to watch. If you get a chance, definitely come check them out inside Bill Gree here, and they'll be here toward the end of the month.
And really a must-watch every single game. We saw a Rattler record set. Etheridge, 20 rebounds in a single game. And afterwards, the really scary thing is her coaches thought that she didn't play her best game. They thought she could have played better.
Yeah, I mean, that's only her second game as a Rattler and already a record breaker. So we got her for four more years, Lord willing.
As a true freshman.
Yeah. Now Wilson on the right side. Here's Monroe, high post, looking. Gonna take it up himself, jump shot. Oh, that's good, gets the roll there.
Very nice soft touch there by Monroe. If your big can hit that shot with consistency, they become incredibly more difficult to guard.
Nice dish, wide open three. That one way hard off the bank. Here's Bauer pushing left side. Now brings it toward the middle. Going to pull it back and reset the offense. So something you like about Bauer. Always a cool customer. Got a lot of experience in the NCAA tournament. And Monroe there with an offensive foul.
I think Hollinger kind of baited it on that one. Knew that Monroe was going to go with the power move there. Had his feet set. Good charge taken by him. Into the game, also Mike Evans for the Javelinas. And here we go, the first time we're gonna see Efi AK this season. The redshirt junior comes in at 6'8". He'll be entering the game for Joe Monroe. And out of Nigeria is Efi AK, another exciting player for St. Mary's, an incredible athlete, which seems to be a theme for the St. Mary's team this year. Great defense there by Alexander. And in transition, Wilson, the three. The advantage for St. Mary's is they're looking to push ahead here in the first half.
Javelinas here, they had a momentary lead. Their three-point lead has evaporated, has turned into a Rattler four-point lead. Here's a three, it's launched, and that's good. Easy for number five, Rashad Basie. He has nine of the Javelinas 15 and just pulls up. Easy jump shot for him.
Yeah, and you're for the Rattlers, you have to not go underneath that screen there. You have to fight over the top and trust your help defense. Basie very well versed in all stages of his game.
There's Alexander, nice hook shot. Simple, effective. Just the way I'm sure Coach Z likes it drawn up.
Well, you know St. Mary's has plenty of plays in the books for their post players.
Here come the Javelinas. Oh, tough jumper, and that one off the glass. It looked like a little bit of offensive interference. Nonetheless, it'll be Rattler basketball. 12:04 remaining here in the opening half. That shot no good by Ronald Scott, and so we'll have more substitutions as we'll have number 21, J.J. Bolton, check in for St. Mary's.
Along with Marvin Witt, who I'm very excited to see. He's going to be the shortest player on the court. He's listed at 5'9". He's just about that, maybe a tiny bit shorter, but an incredible player. It's a great pass and good hesitation there by Alexander.
Good dish there by J.J. Bolton.
Bolton four assists in both of the first two games in Las Vegas. Those two games, of course, the Rattlers split. They lost the first one and won the second one.
Oh, good rotation, but just a better jump shot there by Basie again. He's the first player in double digits for either team. He has 11 and barely 9 minutes gone by. Rattlers are going to have to do a better job on him defensively. I'm not sure why not, we're not putting a taller guy on him. Here's Bolton, jumper, long, no good. Here's Bolton with the rebound. Excuse me, that was Efi. Oh, nice move all the way, and he is hit. That's Ronald Scott breaking down the defender and then getting all the way inside the lane.
That foul going to be on Efi AK. Another media timeout called. We'll head there with him. So you're watching Rattler Basketball on the Rattler Network.
If you drive buzzed, it could cost you around $10,000. You'll face major legal fees, major fines, and steep insurance penalties. You could lose everything. Buzzed, busted, and broke. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
Welcome back, Rattler fans. 20-17 the score between the Rattlers and the Javelinas. David Tovar, Joe Rodriguez with you. At the line is Ronald Scott. He was fouled before the timeout. Remember, Rattler fans, we invite you to join us on Facebook, facebook.com/St. Mary's Rattlers. We're also on Twitter, at St. Mary's Rattlers. On Instagram, same handle, at St. Mary's Rattlers. And of course, to get the gear that the Rattlers are wearing, rattlergear.com. And for everything St. Mary's Athletics, RattlerAthletics.com. First free throw is good. Second free throw is good. Both go in for Scott, and he brings his Javelinas within one.
And speaking of the Rattler gear, David, some new unis being busted out by our men's basketball team here today. Same as what the women were doing. And I don't know about you, I think they're looking very sharp out there.
Indeed they are. And they also have these blue and yellow ones that I think they should be busting out sometime within the year. So just another, just some fashion watch from us up here to keep a look out for Rattler fans. 1 point lead here for the St. Mary's Rattlers. Here's Scott, drops it off. That shot short. Rebound comes out to AK. And Rattlers not able to make that possession happen. A scramble leads to a turnover. Now here come the Javelinas once again. Here's Bailey working against Bolton. Drops it back off to Scott. Calls off his offensive player. Now finds him. McDew. That jumper by Diaz is no good. And now rebound out to Bauer and the Rattlers. Here's Witt. Tough shot. No good. And he is fouled on the way up. That will put Witt at the line.
I already like this from St. Mary's. We've seen them a couple times in transition off of rebounds really push the ball, and it's very effective for them. They're finding their way to the line quite often here in the first half.
I agree. I like the aggressiveness. I like our wing players. They're athletic. Something that we haven't really seen from our wing players in the last two years. And so it's something I hope the coaching staff utilizes. St. Mary's has some athletic wing players, and there you see, we saw earlier Benny, we see Witt here. And this one, good play here defensively by the Rattlers. They get themselves an extra possession off the missed free throw. And just like that, they give it right back away.
And Isaiah Matthews did a great job there of getting that offensive rebound, but then a little bit too aggressive there and fighting for post position. He's going to be called for that offensive foul.
21-19, the score. We're under 10 minutes to go here in the first half. A lot of new faces here for the St. Mary's Rattlers. J.J. Bolton defending. He's joined by Matthews, Alexander, Witt, and Bauer. Bauer, the lone Rattler who has played all 10 minutes and 19 seconds of this game. And just like that, the Javelinas are called for an offensive foul. They'll return possession to the Rattlers.
And a press now from the Javelinas. You see all of their players and the Rattler backcourt. St. Mary's going to have to set up their press break here.
We're going to bring this up the court.
Hey, they broke the press.
Not a lot of resistance put there by the Javelinas. Now Bauer swinging it around. Bolton for three. Gets that to go. That's good. And just like that, J.J. Bolton has his first bucket inside Bill Greehy Arena. And that's good enough for a five-point lead for the St. Mary's Rattlers. Here comes Scott. Tough jumper in traffic. Ooh, gets that to go. Silky smooth release. 21-24.
And with Basley on the bench, Scott seeming to take over a bit more of the scoring role for the Javelinas. Already 4 points for him.
Oh, nice dish by Bauer. A three. That's Witt's good.
And St. Mary's are shooting on point here to start the first half.
27-21. The Rattlers last year, a very good three-point shooting team, had, of course, the sharpshooters, Daryl Taylor, Molson Dufu, Christian Bauer will get into the action, Fred Wilson as well. And I'm liking the range here from Witt, from Bolton. Now Bauer will take a break.
This lineup I'm Benny's very excited for. We've got a couple of Marvins out on the court, Marvin Binney and Marvin Witt. Both newcomers, both very athletic. See how the Rattlers manage with the two of them on the floor together. That's a foul drawn here. That's going to be on Bailey. And that'll put the Rattlers in 1-1, so J.J. Bolton will head to the line. .827 remaining in the first half. St. Mary's will be shooting 1-1 at least for the rest of the way, same as the Javelinas, as St. Mary's has 16 fouls right now.
Free throw by Bolton, no good, and it's rebounded by Hollinger. Now here come the Javelinas, they're trying to push. Oh, that's a tough shot, made look easy by Basie.
And second he comes into the game, not even 5 seconds after he comes on the court, he's got another bucket, and Witt answers right back with a three. Witt, the second three-pointer of the half for him. He's sitting pretty at 7 points.
Did a good job off the bench. And as you mentioned, not exactly the tallest player in stature, but he has not shown any fear in letting it fly. 7 points off the bench, 3-4. Bolton, 4 for Alexander, and that will bring us to a timeout. Rattlers lead it 30-23. We're going to go to our sideline reporter, our third member of our announce team, the great Brian McLuhan. On Brian, you've been down there seeing the Rattlers here, their first game here inside Bill Greehy Arena. A lot of new things, a lot of new faces. Anything new to you in particular?
Well, David, the energy out here is just incredible. The fans and the new players, like you mentioned, providing a lot of energy. And the Rattlers early on have been hitting the three ball, and it's proven beneficial for them with this 7-point lead. Let's see if they can keep this up for the rest of the game. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Brian. And Joe, as you mentioned, Rattlers have been hitting the three. As Brian mentioned, Rattlers have been hitting the three. Got to be a little careful with that, though. Don't want to get too reliant on a three, wouldn't you think?
Yeah, three ball, it eventually will catch up to you. I mean, the percentages eventually. But, David, I know sometimes you're feeling real hot from that three-point line. You feel like you need a little heat check. You know, and if you're really feeling it and it's going to be one of those nights to remember, then sure, go on ahead and do it. But otherwise, you can't fall in love with that three-pointer. And I think the Rattlers have done a good job of that. I mean, they've already drawn 7 fouls. So I think they have that perfect balance so far of attacking the paint and then also being able to knock down those three-pointers. And the three-pointers that they're taking, they're wide-open three-pointers. So as long as the three-pointers are smart, then I'll go on ahead and I'll feel good about them, you know?
Well, that's what I was thinking. I think the three-pointers have been, A, open, and B, they've been off good penetration and some well-created shots. If you got it, flaunt it. Let it fly. At the line is Basie, and he has absolutely let it fly, and he has been flowing tonight. 13 points tonight. We'll get that one. A foul underneath.
I believe they're going to call a lane violation there. So redo the first free throw. David, great turnout here today. Of note in the crowd, we see Moses Sundufu, Daryl Taylor, Coach Charlie Meagle, the baseball coach over there as well, a great number of the baseball players who were actually out at the parks in St. Mary's here today. They were trying out the field. They had an inter-squad scrimmage. Some very good stuff out of them there as we see a first free throw going for Basie. Second one up, and that one no good. A good box out by Matthews. So the Rattlers with the ball with 7:50 remaining in the first half.
Yeah, we see some Rattler alums, as you mentioned, Taylor and Sundufu. Some huge pieces, and there's Witt. Caught for the travel. Substitutions for the Javelina. Javelina's in comes number 50, Mike Evans. And what you might believe is number five, Basie. Well, there is Basie, not able to run to this one. That one comes off the hands. And it'll be a turnover, St. Mary's basketball. A six-point lead, 7.5 remaining here in the first half.
And so far for me, David, the thing I've
loved. What a move there by Benny.
Just not able to finish, but a great move. I really like the depth that St. Mary's has shown so far. They've had several players play on the wing. Even more big men come in. They have a rotating set of four big men. I believe about 9 Rattlers so far have played, and it's great when you have a rotation like that that's able to keep you fresh.
Here's Bolton. Oh, does a good job skinning the cat there. Trying to hold on to that possession. It's off the hands of the Javelinas. It'll stay with the Rattlers under their own basket. Diaz is checked back in for the Javelinas, and Ryan Thomas checks in now. Here's Isaiah Matthews. Flips it over. Witt for three. That one way short. Javelinas now running. Here's Scott. Dumps it off. McDew over to Basie, and that's good. Another easy basket there for Basie. He has 16 of the Javelinas 26. That's very impressive any way you want to slice it.
Yeah, it really was, and that was a great cut by him there. He saw his teammate penetrating, cut to the basket, and was able to get the easy finish.
Now the Javelinas putting pressure on Witt. Able to get it out to Benny. Now Bolton. Nice dish. Bolton to Thomas. And there is Isaiah Matthews with the finish. Offensive board, Isaiah Matthews. We talked about it earlier. Just bigger, bulkier. Has done a great job in the gym, putting in the hard work. He knows he's going to get a lot of reps inside the post. And also, we haven't mentioned this, Isaiah Matthews, not only a terrific ball player, but a terrific video editor, a social media savant. Go to YouTube.com, check out RattleAthletics.com. The men's intro basketball video is up, produced, shot, directed, and produced by Isaiah Matthews. That three, no good. Rattlers with the offensive board.
And again, I like the Rattlers' ability to create and transition there. And going back to Isaiah Matthews, another thing that he did that I've really noticed is he added incredibly to his vertical. He seems to be jumping a great deal higher this season. And of course, if you're a post player and you already have that height, any inch or two that you can add to your vertical is incredibly valuable.
Yeah, when he was brought in here at St. Mary's, he was touted as a terrific athlete, and he's remained an athlete. As you mentioned, he already had a great vertical. Now just adding to it. Good job defensively by Matthews, but just a better shot there by Scott, as that's good enough to bring the score within 4 now.
Fred Wilson just checking into the game and also checking in on the score sheet. He's able to get that one down. Wilson already with 8 points here early in the first half, or in the later stages of the first half now, is at just under five remaining.
Here's Diaz, tough jumper. Audibles, and Wilson diving, able to save that. Here come the Rattlers. Marvin Witt, left side, over to Thomas, down low Matthews. Oh, does a good job evading the fake, and it'll be caught a traveling.
And fans not liking that one there. But I love the great high-low play there. 34-28 for St. Mary's, 4:35 on the clock.
Here's Diaz, jumper, that's good for three.
And Thomas Diaz showing the range there for the big man.
A three-point lead, A&M Kingsville hanging tough. The Rowers have really cooled down from behind the arc. They got to get something going here. Possession is lost, and that is a backcourt. And we get our first look. I don't know if the camera caught it. We got our first Coach Z stomp of the year, at least the one I've caught here. Frustrated with the ball handling here. I don't know if the statisticians are going to keep an official mark of that, but that's another keyworthy stat.
Yes, indeed. And of course, for Coach Z, it's like playing golf. The less foot stops he gets, obviously, the better the Rattlers are doing.
Yeah. Here's Witt. Oh, killer crossover. And a blocking foul is called. That will go against the Javelinas. It's against number four, Ryan Garcia. Bauer about to check back in, but not without another media timeout. We're going to go back to our sideline reporter, Brian McLuhan. Brian, Rattlers have cooled off. You talked about how well they shot from behind the arc from around the wing. They're cooling off, and the score is showing that. What are the Rattlers going to do to get back in this one?
Well, David, the Rattlers, as you said, cooling off. Their defense, though, hasn't been able to find its rhythm, and it's allowed for Texas A&M Kingsville to get back into this game. The Rattler lead now down to three. It'll be interesting to see how the Rattlers close out this half, and hopefully they could close out with a flourish and end the half with a bang.
Indeed. Thank you so much, Brian. Brian McLuhan, the third member of our broadcast team. David Tovar, Joe Rodriguez back up here with you. Joe, the cooling has obviously the shooting has obviously cooled off. A lot of new faces, a lot of mixed rotations we're seeing here from St. Mary's.
Yeah, and that might be part of the fact that the Rattlers are, you know, struggling, so to say, here to get the offense all the way together. You know, it takes a while to get that chemistry together in a mesh. You can practice all you want, but when it comes game time, you know, you got to be able to mesh and, you know, find that rhythm together as a team. And then on the other hand, Rashard Baisley just continuing this incredible pace at the offensive end. He is 16 of the Javelinas, 31 right now. St. Mary's, you might have to start thinking about doubling him and taking him out of the game.
First free throw is good by Witt, and you're absolutely right. I think at half, they're going to have to chit-chat about how to stop Baisley. They put Bolton on him, who's about the same size as he is, and he's done a good job deterring him. But there's 16 points by one guy and a half. I mean, he's got over half of the Javelinas points. That's definitely going to be a point of emphasis at halftime, I would assume.
And then on the other end, St. Mary's, I think, doing a good job of scoring by committee. No one player yet in double figures, I believe. And that actually bodes well for St. Mary's, because if you're able to get that even scoring as a team, then it just makes everybody a weapon on the floor all the time.
Good balanced scoring output by St. Mary's. As you mentioned, nobody in double figures, but you got a lot of guys right around eight, right around six. Got a couple guys from three-pointers. That first free throw is good for the Javelinas, and Ronald Scott, as Justin Alexander will check in for Ryan Thomas.
And Thomas picked up his second foul there. He's going to have to be careful for the rest of the game. He's in foul trouble. That one put up also good for Scott. So with 3:46 remaining, it's a three-point advantage for the Rattlers.
Bauer brings it up the court. Bauer, Wilson, Matthews, Binney, and Alexander. Four to the starting five. Here's Alexander, of course, who played last year, who's had some very good games to open up the year over in Vegas. Bauer trapped, and a foul down low. It will go against the Javelinas on Diaz. And Diaz restrained there momentarily.
And you speak about Justin Alexander. He really stepped up in that tournament last year. Big reason why St. Mary's was able to get all the way to the Sweet 16. He had some huge games for them where he had the contributions, of course, on the offensive end. And then Justin Alexander, of course, a great rebounder. He's another double-double potential guy for St. Mary's.
And we'd be remiss to not talk about Alexander. And he has a huge responsibility this year. Some big shoes to fill. And, well, he just got to step right in there. And I was able to chit-chat with him at Media Day. Very excited to be now one of the prominent players in the post for St. Mary's. And, well, frankly, ready to continue on with the legacy of great posts here in the Rattler basketball program as Matthews knocks down both. And I don't know if you can hear this at home. Just got very quiet. Rattlers letting their Rattlers concentrate as much as possible. It's not like we were inside a testing site or something. That jumper off the front iron, no good. Now Bauer looking to push. 3:14 remaining in the first half.
Bauer doing a very good job on the boards here today. I believe that's his third rebound already, which is great work out of the guard.
Matthews, a lot of contact, no call. Here comes Scott and the Javelinas looking to push. Left side, dumping it off. Hollinger over to Basie. All the way, drawing the contact, no call there. Good defense there by Alexander. And Alexander has to put it down for recreates Chris Webber's infamous moment.
Yeah, great job there by Alexander. You like that he was able to rebound the ball, hold it up high, make sure none of those pesky guards take the ball away from you, and eventually just get it over to your guard. And now drawing the offensive foul, Alexander doing it all. And that'll go against Basie.
Great defense there by Alexander, using that height and using that girth to challenge Basie. Maybe the first time Basie's been truly challenged here in this half. I mean, he does have 16, and right there he's caught for an offensive foul.
Yeah.
On the other end, though, I like Matthews really using his body, using the new muscle he has, pounding the ball down low, just not able to finish.
Yeah, he got grabbed there, so it looks like Matthews will be heading to the free throw line for two more shots as the Rattlers are now in the double bonus.
Matthews with five already in this game. And
three of those coming at the free throw line. He's 3 of 4 from the free throw line here today.
Matthews' first free throw. Rattles good, giving the Rattlers a 6-point lead. Second free throw is good, so Matthews brings his total to 7 on the night. Fred Wilson leading the Rattlers in scoring with 8, Matthews behind him with 7. Scott for 3, that one wild, no good. Rebound comes out to Binney, now Binney driving. Looking, driving it off to Bauer. Bauer going to reset, going to bring it back. A lot of time on the shot clock, 25 seconds remaining. Here's Wilson, left side, trying to make a move. Finds a screen from Alexander. Wilson driving, tough shot, contorts, gets that to go. And just like that, Fred Wilson showing off. Told you, he has low-key athleticism. Timeout called by the Javelinas.
Great job there by Wilson, changing his body mid-air in order to avoid the charge. With that, St. Mary's pushes their advantage to 9. Timeout with 1:43 remaining. We'll head there with them as you're watching Rattler basketball on the Rattler Network.
Oh, those boys are much too much. Those boys are much too much. We got the spirit. We're hot. We can't be stopped. We got the spirit. We're hot. We can't be stopped. We're going to beat them and bust them.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today. Call or visit fatherhood.gov to learn more.
And welcome back, Rattler Nation. 42-33 with 1:40 remaining for St. Mary's in this first half. And Alexander getting caught up there. A reach-in foul called on him. With that, Basie will head to the free throw line for two. Javelina is in the double bonus for their remaining 1:33 of this half.
Rattlers here trying to break this game open. They lead by nine. They've converted on their free throws. They've hit some open jumpers. Even some tough ones like that last one that Wilson hit. That first free throw is good for the Javelinas. Rattlers built a lead earlier in this half with some good shooting, and they return to that. Hopefully they can keep that up here at the second half. About a buck 30 remaining in this first half as the second free throw is good.
And I like the substitution here. Basie coming out of the game. He already has two fouls to go along with his 18 points. They were going to go on ahead, use him for that offensive possession. And now Ryan Garcia coming in to play the defense the rest of the way and keep him out of foul trouble.
Benny over to Matthews. Top of the key. Now Bauer looking, surveying the court. Now Wilson Alexander. Alexander a little too far out. Bauer call for a traveling, and I'm trying to get set, but
I think they call him because he didn't have both feet come down at the same time when he caught that pass, so a travel there.
A little bit of hesitation maybe from Bauer. As that jumper is good. Tough shot there. That's number 22. Taquan McDew for two. 5-point lead now. Rattlers had a 9-point lead, now five. Here's Alexander down low, gets that to go. Good job there by Alexander, really establishing himself in the post.
Man, I really love the high-low play. It's one of my favorites in basketball. When you can get your post passing like that, it's reminiscent of the good old Spurs days, the Twin Towers.
Oh, how about them Spurs? Foul on that play. Well, excuse me, out of bounds.
25 on the shot clock, 36 on the game clock.
Javelinas will start from behind the halfway.
And a moving screen there.
Moving screen, that's a turnover unforced. Rattlers will get possession in exactly 30 seconds remaining in this first half. Wilson, Bauer, Benny, Matthews, and Alexander.
And Hollinger just picked up his third foul. He's going to have to be exceptionally careful for the second half.
He's tied for their tallest player on this team at 6'7". So A&M Kings will need all the height they can get. And the Rattlers will take a timeout. We'll take one with them. 7-point lead. 16-point lead remaining in the first half. Stay with us. You're watching Rattler Network.
Foods to the right temperature using a food thermometer. 3,000 Americans will die from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
Welcome back. The last 15 seconds of the half here. David Tovar, Joe Rodriguez bringing the opening game. Inside Bill Greer here for the men's basketball team. Bauer down low to Alexander. Deep in the post. That one just creeps out of the basket. And that will do it. At the half, the St. Mary's Rattlers lead it 44-37. Stay with us. More upcoming. Rattler basketball live on the Rattler Network.
We got the spirit. We're hot. We can't be stopped. We got the spirit. We're hot. We can't be stopped. We're going to beat them and bust them.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life.
Let's get a little bit rowdy. R-O-W-D-Y.
Take time to be a dad today. Call or visit fatherhood.gov to learn more.
NFC, AFC, offensive linemen, defensive tackles, quarterbacks, and cornerbacks are all living united to ensure the academic success of millions of kids in our communities all the way to graduation day. But that won't happen without you. So take the pledge at unitedway.org. Make a difference in the life of a child. Suit up like your favorite NFL players and become a volunteer reader, tutor, or mentor with United Way.
Fans, we welcome you to the halftime show. Just under 9 minutes remaining.
Before we get on to the halftime show, Joe, I gotta talk about Bill Greehy, the new ambiance inside Bill Greehy Arena. All season long, Rattler fans, there's plenty of opportunities for you guys to come check out All the action's going on, a revamped stadium experience. We got half-court shot, we got a lot of promotions coming. So RattleAthletics.com, you get the whole schedule. And hey, plan out your next vacation to Bill Greer Arena. But back to you, Joe. We'll talk some statistics here as the Rattlers get it by 7 over the Javelinas, 44-37.
Well, 44-37, just as you said. And for St. Mary's, the field goal percentage looking on point, exactly where you want it. They're shooting 51.9%, while the Javelinas are hovering at 43.3%. If you're St. Mary's, you also have to love what your team's doing at the three-point line. They're shooting 62.5%. Javelinas also doing a great work at the three-point line. They're shooting 44.4%. And St. Mary's, 14 free throw attempts in that first half. They converted on 11 of them. Really a great number for them overall.
A lot of positives here for St. Mary's. And I want to just harp a little bit on all the new faces we've seen. Marvin Binney, I've been so impressed with him. I've already had to compare him to a basketball player I'm more familiar with. Russell Westbrook, he's got the height, 6'3", and he's so explosive, can get all the way to the rim. I've really enjoyed J.J. Bolton. I've seen him make some great passes, good defender, has a lot of length. And, of course, Marvin Witt. Marvin Witt played really well, as we talked about, small in stature, but he really played big. Hitting some big three-pointers for the St. Mary's Rattlers in that first half. And, of course, I can't leave out the familiar faces. Fred Wilson playing very well alongside Bauer. And Justin Alexander really taking and making the most out of his opportunity inside the post for the Rattlers.
Yeah, and if you're the St. Mary's, you really have to love a lot of the things that your players are doing. One of the most impressive things to me, Fred Wilson. He's an incredibly improved passer this season.
Yeah.
It's on full display. He's doing great work for the Rattlers. And then also at the offensive end, he's leading the team, 10 points for him. And then also Witt right behind him with 9. So the scoring is very, very balanced for St. Mary's. Then on the other side, who can forget Basie, the incredible half he had. He scored 18 of the 37 points for the Javelinas. And also Scott, also a good half for him. He scored 8 points, but he did it on 33% shooting. Basie, he did it on 7 of 11 shooting, so very impressive out of him. But another thing of note about Basie, 2 fouls already on him in that first half, so he's going to have to be careful for the rest of the game.
Indeed. Well, that should gear us up toward an exciting second half. Very interesting second half, to say the least. Rattler fans, keep it right here with us. We'll be back right around 6 minutes until we get right back on the court. Here, St. Mary's Rattlers lead 44-37 over the A&M Kingsville Javelinas. Stay with us. David Tovar, Joe Rodriguez bringing you men's basketball on Rattler Network.
Every day, kids witness bullying.
Why are you stabbing me with it?
No,
they want to help,
but
don't know how.
Teach
your kids how to be more than a bystander. Visit stopbullying.gov.
kitchen surfaces, utensils, and hands with soapy water. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
Fans, exactly 2 minutes remaining until we begin the second half. We implore you, stay tuned. Rattlers leading 44-37 as we're going into the second half for what should be a very exciting conclusion against the Texas A&M University Kingsville Javelinas.
Looking for these? You drive buzzed, it could be one very expensive ride.
First, you gotta make bail. Then pay me to get your car back.
Your insurance premiums will go through the roof.
And my legal fees just keep adding up. All told, it could end up costing you $10,000.
Buzzed, busted, and broke. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
NFC, AFC, offensive linemen, defensive tackles, quarterbacks, and cornerbacks are all living united to ensure the academic success of millions of kids in our communities all the way to graduation day. But that won't happen without you. So take the pledge at unitedway.org. Make a difference in the life of a child. Suit up like your favorite NFL players and become a volunteer reader, tutor, or mentor with United Way.
To start the second half, St. Mary's, of course, at advantage 44-37. A lot of bright stories and bright points for the Rattlers, along with their newcomers here to start the year. Fred Wilson leading the Rattlers in scoring in that first half. He has 10, but on the other end, Basie, as he gets fouled and.
See if they're going to count it.
I believe the call will be on the floor, and they're going to take it out of bounds. So. Basie sitting at 18 points. Wilson, that foul, his second. So he'll have to be careful not to pick up his third. And another foul called there on Matthews, and he didn't like the call. The referee couldn't see the ball there, but Matthews thought he got the jump ball, but call made, and already the Rattlers, two quick fouls coming out here in the second half, and that'll be a shooting foul, so for St. Mary's, definitely not the way you want to start the second half of these fouls.
Matthews wanted the jump ball there, not going to get it. First free throw for the Javelinas is no good. And, well, Rattler fans take solace in the old saying, ball don't lie.
Yes, indeed.
As the first one is no good for Robert Powell, the 6'5" junior forward for the Javelinas. Next shot is up. And it's no good, so two straight, but Powell grabs his own all the way. And this is an offensive foul, so the Rattlers will get possession back here. And absolutely right around 30 seconds gone down here in the second half. Not the way you want to start if you're the St. Mary's Rattlers.
Yeah, but I really like the recognition out of Benny there. He saw the offensive rebound, He didn't start going down the court for transition, assuming his team would get the rebound, able to make the defensive play there.
Here's Bauer, right side to Wilson, and now down low to Thomas, and Thomas gets that bucket. 5 points for Thomas.
And that's what I've talked about, the passing from Wilson. He's very decisive when he gets that ball and knows exactly what he's going to do with it. And also, a good job by Thomas there. We can't forget how important it is for a postman to get position down low.
Oh, tough jumper there by Scott as he answers right back. An impressive jump shot of his own. Once again, brings the Rattler lead down to 7.
Yeah, it's been the Scott and Basley show. And great hustle there by Bauer. He's able to not have the turnover. Here's a three by Wilson. Oh, it doesn't go in, but Thomas able to corral another possession for St. Mary's.
Pretty pass there by Benny as he's able to hold on to possession, slow it down. They're going to try this one again. Benny, I've been super impressed with him. Here he is with possession, loses the handle, gains it back. Now 15 on the shot clock for the Rattlers. Dumps it off, right side Bauer, driving, stops. Oh, good dish, threading the needle. And that's a two-pointer for Isaiah Matthews.
And Bauer right there, the pump fake over, the pass fake over to the corner, really drawing the defense, able to have a bullet pass by Matthews. Great catch by your big man there with the easy lane for two. Oh, Benny now fighting for the rebound, able to take it away. Good effort by him there.
He's been all over the place here to begin the second half. Now Wilson for three. That one well defended, just a little short, takes a couple of bounces on the rim. Here come the Javelinas. Ooh, nice dish by Basie. Basie showing off the offensive arsenal there. Nice dish inside, and just like that, once again, the Javelinas cut this to 7.
And St. Mary's, we discussed it in the first half, maybe falling in love with the three ball a little bit. Wilson, he's been offline on a couple of threes here to start the half. St. Mary's needs to look to establish inside the paint first before they can fire those threes.
Turnaround jump shot, that is good. That's Robert Powell bringing the Javelinas within 5, and quickly Coach Z will go to his bench. J.J. Bolton at the scorer's table.
Irving Hollinger also at the scorer's table for the Javelinas. Clean strip there by Diaz.
Now Scott driving, stop, brings it back. Diaz lining up for 3, gets around Thomas, nice dish.
Oh,
and
rejection.
A rejection by Thomas.
And you love seeing your big man rotate over there, able to give the help defense as he rejected Bailey.
Bailey wide open, maybe with a pump fake, could have scored, but instead looks to get fancy with it.
Hollinger back on the court for the Javelinas. He has 3 fouls, so he has to be careful out there. Oh. That one put in.
Bolton.
And Basie just making it look too easy right there.
Yeah, Bolton jumps on that fake right there, and Basie, an easy entry into the basket. A 3-point lead now for the Rattlers as Basie has 19. Here's Benny, looking for a screen, waves it off. Now working against Basie. Here's Benny, nice screen. Benny down to Thomas. Bolton picks it up. Benny has it's a long three. That one way off the front iron. No good. And here come the Javelinas driving again. 16 minutes remaining in regulation as that shot counts. And the foul. What a shot, Ronald Scott. Wally Ronald Scott has also played very well for the Javelinas. He has 10 tonight.
I believe they actually ended up calling it on the floor. He is waving it off, so no harm there for St. Mary's quite yet, but already their third team foul. This one fired up for 3 and good for Bailey. And just like that, we're knotted at 48. So the Javelinas coming out firing here to start the second half.
What a terrific run by the Javelinas. They are right back in it, all even at 48. Here's Bolton driving right side. Tough move, gets that to go. J.J. Bolton. Witt and Alexander at the scorer's table for the St. Mary's Rowers.
I love the midair adjustion out of Bolton there, able to get that one to go for 2.
Here is Basie, steps into this one. That jump shot, no good. Corralled by Bolton. Now here comes Bauer. looking to slow it down, and well, ooh, Bauer.
Benny tripped up there.
And he's going to talk about Bauer, and you know, it's kind of a, well, all coins are two-sided. You like that your point guard can slow it down and try to make a decision, but at the same time, you want him to push it and really create some offense. That's one of the best means of easy points. Nonetheless, we'll see what the Rattlers have in store. 15-12 remaining in the second half. Stay with us. Rattlers up by two on the Rattler Network.
Foods to the right temperature using a food thermometer. 3,000 Americans will die from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
Welcome back, Rattler Nation. 15-10 on the game clock, 30 on the shot clock for St. Mary's. It's Christian Bauer taking the ball right. Free throw line extended. St. Mary's a two-point advantage right now, but the Javelinas really storming back, able to make the push here and make this a very close game. Nice teardrop there by Bauer, but just falls off the rim, and the rebound is cleared by the Javelinas.
Now here comes A&M Kingsville. Scott working against Bauer. Scott's played very well, 10 points for him on the night. Dropping that off to McDew. Now Diaz for three. He's knocked down a couple, making another there. And that three-pointer is good. What did McDew?
And Diaz, a very much a dual threat on that pick and roll. He can pop, he can roll. Able to show that he's had the range. And here's Thomas. Oh, a little contact, but still able to finish strong as he puts St. Mary's right back in front.
A good old up and under for Thomas. Gets that to go. 52-51 the score here. Now McDew. Screened by Diaz. Doubled. Oh, Bauer. Good job trying to read it. And Bauer arguing. It came off the leg of Diaz.
And I love the recognition there by Bauer. He saw the pick and pop. They already ran it a couple times, and this time he was able to come over, just barely missed out on a steal there.
Good job by Bauer, like a good cover corner. Something our Cowboys in need, desperately.
Very desperately.
Left side is, oh, that's rejected.
And Joe Monroe announces his way into the game, and now the Rattlers in transition. Here's Bauer.
Gets that to go. Tough jumper there by Bauer. As he gets that to go, Hollinger reject on the other side. Leads to easy points in transition. The good old defense leads to offense. Here's McDew. Now Hollinger. And bad boxing out there by the Rattlers. Allows easy points for the Javelinas.
Yeah, I saw Justin Alexander come over, give the help defense. You then have to help the helper by boxing out their man.
Monroe, they pick. Now Bauer.
He gets stripped there. Ball goes out of bounds. 21 on the shot clock. 13-3 on the game clock. Inbounded to Monroe, and straight away up with the left hand.
Rattlers here trying to hold the Javelinas at bay. Risky pass. Diaz able to catch it. Now here is Hollinger. Tough. Stays with it. And he is fouled. Bailed out at the 11th hour. And so Hollinger will go to the line.
That one called on Joe Monroe. That's his third foul. Again, only five fouls in collegiate play, so Monroe two away from that number.
First free throw, way short by Hollinger. Hey, speaking of our Cowboys, Joe, Ed Reed released by the Texans. Any chance you want him?
Yeah,
I do too.
Absolutely.
He's better than anything we got.
You'd need a playmaking safety out there for the Tampa 2 defense. Absolutely. More importantly, though, you need to get Sean Lee back healthy, my favorite player.
That's a huge blow. That may have been the worst day of that game, seeing Lee go down again.
Yeah, it's
only played 13 games in what, two, three seasons?
Yeah, very unfortunate. The numbers he was putting up, he looked like he could make a run at defensive MVP. But now back to the Rattlers. Second free throw, good. 56-54 with 12:30 left. Bauer, left free throw line extended. He's looking for Alexander in the post. Instead, over to Witt, 4-3. No good, but Monroe doing good work on the offensive boards. Piles over a Javelina player and then trips over him. And on the line was Scott. So the ball will stay with St. Mary's, and you gotta love the bigs. Nice and active there on the offensive end.
Yeah, the hustle rewarded there for St. Mary's with the whistle, the referee blowing their way. Here comes Witt. Oh, nice pass. Here's Monroe. Look at the sky.
Goodness.
And a blocking foul called. Monroe trying to show all that athleticism.
And he was trying to jump over Robert Powell like it was Rattler madness.
Oh, my goodness. Monroe, very lucky that the defense wasn't set. That was an optimistic move by Monroe, and it earns him a shot at the line.
We're only three games into the season, but we're already looking at the play of the year there if he was able to drop the hammer.
First free throw is good by Monroe. Monroe has 6 points here in his home debut. This is the men's basketball home debut. The women already taking the court here at Bill Greer Arena. They were successful in both their outings, one against A&M Kingsville and one against Angelo State on Friday and Saturday, as both free throws are good for Monroe. Right around 12 minutes remaining here in the second half. Looking ahead, the Rattlers will be back on Saturday afternoon, 3 p.m. against Texas Lutheran. You can catch that here inside Bill Greer Arena and, of course, on RattlerAthletics.com. Here's Diaz, left side. Oh, under the basket. Nice move. A little bit out of control. And finally, Monroe able to come up with it. Oh, a little slippery there.
Good patience by Monroe there. He wasn't baited into the early feed.
Oh, good move there by Witt. And better finish there by Alexander.
I love the Rattlers. At least three white jerseys around the rim there. Able to get the follow. And they push the lead back to six with 11:20 left in the half.
Here is Scott, dumps it off. Now Hollinger. Diaz, swinging around. Rattler defense has been terrific here. Swarming all the way through, and ooh, not very good defense there, just allowing Hollinger to waltz in the lane.
And Alexander was willing to give Hollinger the left hand there. Hollinger took it with the left hand, was able to get the two.
Now Witt. Very interesting combination guard is Witt. Kind of smaller than a point guard. And yet he's a two guard with Bauer running the point. Here's Alexander again. Alexander has been terrific here, Joe. 10 points for him.
And St. Mary's bigs have really taken over right now. They're just playing so much bigger than the Javelina bigs, as you would say. They're a lot taller, a lot stronger. They've been rebounding a whole lot better. And with that, the Javelinas take a timeout. We'll keep it here, though, and we're going to head over to our sideline reporter, Brian McGlueyon. Brian, 10:30 left in this game. We've seen what the Rattlers have done to come out for the second half. What do they have to keep doing in order to maintain this lead, and what can they do better?
The Rattlers, Joe, they need to just keep attacking the boards. They have the definite size advantage over the Javelinas, and it was evident right there in that mini run they had prior to the timeout. As well, the Javelinas have been able to take advantage of several open three-pointers. The Rattlers should improve on that as the game progresses into the later stages. Other than that, the Rattlers definitely have their grasp on this game for now. Hopefully they can keep it up as the game moves on.
All right, Well, thank you very much, Brian. A great report, as always. David, I absolutely love the new sideline reporter features that we have with the Rattler Network. One of the many features that we have with the brand new Rattler Network, and of course the most notable, the HD broadcast. Not only the picture better on your screen, but the voices coming through it a lot clearer now and a lot more beautiful, would you say?
Indeed. HD, the Rattler Network, and that of course bringing the brainchild of the mad scientist, Chad Peters, our sports information king, Rob Johnson, the departed Scott Fonger, who is, in my mind, at some beach probably right now, with his feet kicked up and
an adult beverage in his hand,
milk. He's having a blast, but definitely those people putting it together, and yeah, great quality. If you're checking us out for the first time this season, welcome aboard Rattler Network HD. 62-56 the score. David Tovar, Joe Rodriguez. Timeout taken. And we'll take it with them, Rattler fans. Stay with us. More upcoming second half of the Rattler basketball opening night here from Bill Greer Arena.
Looking for these? You drive buzzed. It could be one very expensive ride.
First, you gotta make bail. Then pay me to get your car back.
Your insurance premiums will go through the roof.
And my legal fees just keep adding up. All told, it could end up costing you $10,000.
Buzzed, busted, and broke. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
Welcome you back, Rattler Nation. 10:22 on the game clock as the Rattlers battle the Javelinas of Texas A&M University Kingsville. Alexander able to clear another board there as he's really started to surge in the second half. Here's Bolton going baseline. Monroe, oh! Misses the putback stuff, but he draws the foul. Monroe, very aggressive coming out here in the second half, trying to bring the house down.
Well, he's just showing off the athleticism at this point. Got to finish it, though. And right now, he has a chance to finish it here at the free throw line. Monroe, 6 points for him out of San Antonio Stevens. A prominent member of this Rattler team, a redshirt junior. First free throw off the mark, no good. Five on the floor for the St. Mary's Rattlers. Bauer, Witt, Bolton, Monroe, and Alexander. Substitution for the Javelinas. Mike Evans comes in for Hollinger. They have Basie, Diaz, Bailey, and Scott. Basie and Scott, they've been terrific.
Yeah, that seemed to be the 1-2 punch here for the Javelinas. The kind roll on the home rim for Joe Monroe there. As he converts on one of the two free throws.
63-56 the score. As Basie looking for a screen. Alexander coming way out on him. And a foul caught. And, I agree with Alexander's reaction. Not sure what he did there.
Yeah, tiniest bit of contact there. I thought Alexander did a good job of moving his feet, but the call going against him there as Basie draws it. That'll be the 16th foul on St. Mary, so the Javelinas will be in the bonus for the rest of the half.
Here is Scott, drops it off to Basie. Now in the paint, having a retreat. Great defense played by Witt, the smaller Witt, giving up about 3-4 inches to Basie, and he is really... Another foul caught here, that's on Witt. 1-1 upcoming, but Witt really giving Basie a battle out there in the wing.
Yeah, and Witt, really the speed and quickness, a different look than they've been giving Basie all night. A bit more height usually for Basie, but Witt, I like the change of pace, a little bit more speed and quickness, able to tip the ball away, but unfortunately called for the foul. 1-1 at the line for Basie. And that one no good. The board cleared by Alexander. Here comes Bauer. I feed it off to Witt. Witt looking up high for Monroe, and oh!
Could have scored that one on his own, and this one will be Rattler basketball as it looks like it's Basie hits the deck. Trying to save that. A good hustle there from Basie. He has 19 points on the night. How many of those came in the first half, Joe? 16, 17 of those?
I believe 17, yes, in the first half.
So Rattlers have done a better job holding him, and it shows on the scoreboard. A 7-point lead right now for the Rattlers as we are just a little bit midway through this second half. 9:24 remaining. Here's Alexander to Witt. A fresh shot clock for the Rattlers here to operate. Down low is Monroe, and they feed it to him. Turns around, shoots, tough jumper, that's good.
Monroe really bringing great energy for this entire half. He has 9 points, all of them in this half, really helping lead the Rattlers here. They're going to call another blocking foul on Alexander there. And again, he disagrees with the call.
Ryan Thomas will check in for Alexander as Alexander picks up his third.
For Justin Alexander.
Basie again heading to the line for another free throw. Possibly two in this 1-1 situation.
Roddy Rowler is trying to distract Basie, and they do here as Basie misses that free throw off the back iron.
The usual antics for the Rowdy Rattlers working there.
Yeah. Here's Monroe down low. Big dunk.
Third time the charm on the jam there for Monroe, and he pushes the Rattler advantage to 11.
Timeout taken by the Javelinas, and the Rattler bench is all fired up after the Monroe dunk. 67-56. Stay with us. More upcoming from Bill Greer Arena. You're watching Rattler Basketball on Rattler Network.
Oh, those boys are much too much. Those boys are much too much.
We got the spirit. We're hot. We can't be stopped. We got the spirit. We're hot. We can't be stopped. We're going to beat them and bust them.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today. Call or visit fatherhood.gov to learn more.
And we welcome you back to Bill Greehey Arena, Rattler fans. 67-56, the advantage for St. Mary's as there's 8:39 left on the game clock. Javelina is needing to call the timeout. There is Joe Monroe. Oh,
looking to get that one, but a good layup there by the Javelinas over the extended Monroe. Here come the Rattlers with. Here's Monroe going to take a jumper, and that one just a little short, no good. Rebound comes out to the Javelinas. And now the Javelinas pushing. Here's Bozy, met by Monroe and Thomas, excuse me. That one's off the mark. Javelinas with it.
Good hustle by the Rattler big men there in order to get back. And a blocking foul going to be called here.
Just a little late on the whistle was the official as Monroe and the rest of the Rattlers peeved.
It's going to be on Monroe, his fourth, so one more and he's done. He has to be careful for the remaining 8:03.
Let's see what the... Nope, I was going to say, let's see if the Rattler coaches elect to ride with him, but they'll bring Matthews in. Just trading athlete for athlete here. Great show Monroe has, well, at first attempted to put on, and finally did put on with a huge dunk. I mean, it's... Still not over the first dunk he tried. He was looking to leap over someone.
Yes, he was. I suppose he practiced that in the offseason. Was that part of the offseason workout? I wasn't aware of it.
Neither was I. I don't know who volunteered, which of the managers on the team volunteered to be his practice dummy. as that free throw is no good. 67-58, the score remains.
And the antics of the Rowdy Rattlers once again. It's something that you really have to come out to the game to appreciate, and we strongly encourage that you do so. This environment tonight is rocking.
Here are the Rattlers. Matthews down low. He gets a part of the action there. Nice layup there for Matthews as he has 9 points. Some balanced scoring, as we've mentioned here.
It's more and more apparent as this game goes on. The Rattler bigs just taking over the game, and Matthews with the rejection there.
Here's Bauer now. Bolton to his left, looking down low. Here's Ryan Thomas holding off to Bauer. And Bauer going to be called for stepping out of bounds. And Coach Z frustrated with the referees, frustrated with his players. Unforced errors, that'll definitely turn a coach's hair from gray to white.
Yes, indeed. But immediate timeout. We'll go on ahead and head there with them. An 11-point advantage for your St. Mary's Rattlers.
Cheerleaders, Joe. David Tovar, Joe Rodriguez back here with you. Joe, you talk about the in-game environment here at Delcor Arena, totally revamped. We have so many things going on, in-game promotions. We're giving away prizes. We're giving away money giveaways. Cold Blue Dance Team, the Rattler Cheerleaders. Meet Joe and I here. That's any bit of an added incentive and an added bonus here to check out Delcor Arena. And of course, Rattler basketball taking center stage. They lead it by 11.
And of course, the pregame antics as well. SGA, a little bit of a cookout here today. They were giving out the foam fingers. These are some very cool foam fingers
we have right here, David. Cool. We'll be tweeting them, I'm sure, but cool foam fingers. If you haven't seen one, check Miley Cyrus' VMA performance, as that is good for the Javelinas. They now are within single digits. Here's Bolton, an open three, and it's rejected by Basie, and staying with it is Bolton. He gets that to go. A two-pointer there by Bolton.
I love the tenacity there by Bolton.
Yeah, he's got to be happy being able to regain that possession and finish it off. 11-point lead once again. Here is Bailey, and he is hit.
Bolton getting the strip right there, too, at the last minute. Great job by him, able to take the ball away from Bailey. And then forcing the turnover there. Great inbounds defense by the Rattlers as a whole. And they'll have the ball here with 6:29 remaining in the first half. The Javelinas applying the full court pressure. Ball given off to Bauer. He'll bring it up the court. Javelinas really just picking up full court there. Bauer loses his dribble, has to pick it up, but Isaiah Matthews right there, and he draws the foul. Matthews doing a great job of forcing the action today. He's heading the free throw line once again.
Matthews with 11. Has played a relatively clean game, only two fouls so far. Right around 6 minutes remaining here in the second half. Diaz checking in for Hollinger. For the A&M Kingsville side, here is Matthews at the line. Gonna calmly take the first jumper, and that is good. A 12-point lead now.
And that foul on Hollinger was actually his fifth, so he's done for the game. So Second free throw by Matthews, also good. So Rattlers, very good job at the free throw line here today. Now push their advantage to 13. Here's Scott, he'll get off to Baisley. And another blocking foul is going to be called against St. Mary's. And get Ryan Thomas here. That's a 10th team foul against St. Mary's. Thomas, his third foul. So Baisley will be shooting in the double bonus, as will the Javelinos for the remaining 6:04.
The halves, a tale of two cities for Baisley. 17 in the first half, only four here, as he misses that free throw off the front iron. And I don't know, Joe, me thinks that maybe switching sides of the court to the more rambunctious side, Roddy Rattlers inhabiting this side of the court, maybe Baisley, maybe a little affected by it as he gets that second free throw to go calmly, 61-73.
And he seems to have cooled off a little bit since that first half, but still 22 points for him, very impressive. That matches his total that he had last game in that exhibition against UTPA.
Here is Bauer, drops it off to Witt on the right side. Witt now dribbling, resets for Bauer, 15 on the shot clock for the St. Mary's Rattlers. Two screens for Bauer to choose from, lines one up, down low is Thomas, he is stripped. Got a good look at that one.
And Coach Zell's not happy with that one. Alexander's going to be immediately called into the game for Thomas.
Blocking foul down low for the Rattlers. I think that's stop number three for Coach Zelznak. Unofficial count here. So, you know, Tovar's take is out. It's on rattlerathletics.com. Check it out.
A great read, as always.
Thank you so much. And, you know, during soccer season, you know, I had the unofficial then provided by official stats, but the unofficial Great Rattler Goal Race, highlighting our two leading goal scorers in Rattler soccer, both on men's and women's. Maybe this time around for basketball season, maybe the Coach Zelznak home court stomps. How many stomps will he put a hole in the ground?
Well, we are at three right now. I believe that statistic is correct.
We'll have to
write that down in your notes.
Yeah, we're going to have to take tallies and then add them all together toward the end. And this is only accounting for the home games, at least the games that I'll be present for. First free throw is good. Second one is good, too. 63-73. Alexander checks back in. The Javelinos is playing a lot of press, I should say. And Alexander drops it off to Witt. Now Bauer all the way in the back. Now one-on-one here with Scott. Gets past him. Good job there by Bauer. Great handling. Drops that off to Matthews. Had a wide open shot. Opting for a better look. Here's Witt for three. Way off the mark. Alexander with the offensive board and going to set it right back up for Bauer. Love the height Alexander provides. A transfer from Central Connecticut. And there is Alexander right on cue.
Yeah, good job there of keeping his feet, able to contain himself, being strong with the ball, and of course a strong finish.
12-point lead. That shot altered by the Rattler defense. Here comes Bolton driving, going to slow it down. Drops it off to Bauer. Here's Bolton. Oh, nice pass. Matthews down low. Matthews again. Able to finish off. Matthews, nice night he's had. 15 points, I believe, leading all Rattlers in scoring.
Yes, indeed. And Bolton, a great play there. He could have elected for that mid-range jumper, but instead looked for the better shot. And Isaiah Matthews able to provide the finish.
Baisley, no good. Tough layup. And he forces Bolton out. That'll be a foul. It'll go against Baisley. And Jill, something I want to talk about. Great defense by Marvin Witt. He's 5'9", and he's matching up against Baisley, 6'4". So he's giving up, not a math major, right around 6 inches almost on Baisley. And he has kept up with him, and he has really deterred the scoring. I assume the lower center of gravity, able to reach for the ball with a lower stance, he's made life very tough on Baisley in the second half.
Yeah, and a lot more quickness out of Witt. He's always up in the jersey of Baisley. It makes it very, very difficult. St. Mary's going to take a timeout here with 3:55 remaining on the clock. We're going to head on over to our sideline reporter, Brian Maglione. Brian, the St. Mary's big men really taking over this game. What else have you been seeing out of St. Mary's down there on the floor?
St. Mary's, Joe, continuing to work it in the post. The likes of Justin Alexander and Isaiah Matthews, and of course Joe Monroe, who came off and just sparked the Rattlers on that mini run earlier on. Look for the Rattlers to continue pushing the pace a little bit. Actually, rather than pushing the pace, slowing down the pace, killing some time, and taking care of possession. And if they do that, they'll be able to close out this game.
Brian, you talk about killing time. Ooh, kill him. Thank you so much, Brian. Brian Maglione on the sidelines for us. David Tovar, Joe Rodriguez, high atop Bill Greer Arena. Of course, come check us out. Saturday is the next home game against Texas Lutheran. Benny out to Witt. Witt back off to Benny.
And then, of course, Rattler fans, remind you, you know, if the broadcasts are not enough of me and David for you, we always have our weekly webisodic hit series, Talking Rattlers, to feed your Rattler addiction, and of course where the banter is never out of season. Timeout on the floor here. It's the final media timeout. So you're watching Rattler Basketball on the Rattler Network.
Looking for these? You drive buzzed. It could be one very expensive ride.
First, you gotta make bail. Then pay me to get your car back.
Your insurance premiums will go through the roof.
And my legal fees just keep adding up. All told, it could end up costing you $10,000.
Buzzed, busted, and broke. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
Welcome back, Rattler fans. David Tovar, Joe Rodriguez bringing the last 3:36 of Rattler basketball against A&M Kingsville. And Joe, you like to ask me, I'm going to beat you to the punch today. Player of the game for the St. Mary's Rattlers tonight.
Oh, well, I'm going to go on ahead. I'm going to go with Isaiah Matthews. He's been very effective from the field. Shot 3 of 5 on the defensive end. He's done great work. But the thing I like about his game most today is that he's been getting to the free throw line consistently and knocking down those free throws. He's 7 of 8 from the free throw line, something that Houston fans would be envious out of for their big man.
And Matthews, very, very familiar with Houston. He's from Texas City, Texas, very close to Houston, so I'm sure he's wired up indeed tonight. I want to tell you, maybe a career night for him. 15 for him. Good output for Matthews here. I'm going to go with Alexander. He's been terrific. He's got 12 and 8. He's been terrific, really asserting himself. And well, I chit-chatted with him on media day, and I asked him, hey, listen, you're going to have a big role here in the post this season. And he's really embraced it tonight. 12 and 8. Those are numbers similar of someone that we were very familiar with seeing.
Yep, and even more impressive as Matthews, the offensive rebound there, but it gets rejected. But even more impressive about Alexander's night, shooting 6 of 7 from the field. So the picture of efficiency for Justin Alexander.
Yeah, his PER must be off the charts.
2:40 remaining in the second half.
A 14-point lead for the Rattlers. Here is Witt behind the back. Here is Thomas driving it off to Witt. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Bauer for three. Bang!
That's something that Bauer's really worked on in the offseason. You can tell his three-point stroke not only looks more confident, but a lot smoother, and it's another dimension that he can add to his game. Kind of makes him a little bit more Jason Kidd-like, I guess you could say, toward the end of his career. And Bauer, of course, as we know, a great assist guy.
Yeah, no, very true. Bauer, last season, really had, you know, at times showed off the rest of his offensive arsenal. We know he's a skilled passer. We know he's a terrific game manager, but good shooter, can hit the open three, and can drive. When he would drive, he would really throw defenses off. So you really have to account for Bauer at times if you're the opposing defense. Bauer tonight with 5, knocking down that three-pointer, and his Rattlers are up by 17. What an impression they've made on this crowd. As we look forward to our next home game, it'll be on Saturday afternoon, 3 o'clock, against Texas Lutheran here inside Bill Greehey Arena. Rattlers here looking to take game one of a 5-game homestand. On the 19th, they'll be taking against St. Tom. They'll be up against St. Thomas. Then after Thanksgiving on the 29th, they'll be taking on Central Missouri. And then against Emporia State on the 30th. Those two last games will be part of the St. Mary's Thanksgiving Classic, a yearly staple. After the turkey, come walk it off as you walk up the stairs here in Bill Greehey Arena. And after some football, some great basketball here from the St. Mary's Rattlers.
Yes, indeed. And of course, we remind you, in order to keep up with all those action, or even to look at the schedule yourself, go to rattlerathletics.com. Also, follow us on all social media, facebook.com/St. Mary's Rattlers. And of course, follow us on Twitter and Instagram at St. Mary's Rattlers for all your favorite Rattler interesting statistics and, of course, pictures.
Under the 2-minute warning here for the St. Mary's Rattlers. They'll look to eat as much clock as they possibly can here. A successful outing here for St. Mary's on their opening night. A&M Kingsville, always a good matchup as that three is launched no good by Witt. Here comes Bolton. Now back to Bauer.
EFAK checking in that last timeout.
AK joining Thomas, Benny, Witt, and Bauer. And Witt, bad pass there. Here come the Javelinas. Here's Basie. He's going to draw the foul. And it looked like he used his offhand to kind of attempt to clear Bauer out of the way.
Now he's going to head to the free throw line for a couple more. Also, another thing of note, the Javelinas in a zone defense there. Possibly seeing the writing on the wall and deciding to try to work on something in the later stages of the game.
Bauer there, arguing with the official, trying to plead his case. That foul is against Bauer. It's his third of the game.
And we talked about Christian Bauer very briefly, but a thing that I also want to bring up, and again, the fashionista in you and me coming out here a little bit, David. I always like Bauer's kicks. They're always very, very nice.
Yeah, and always very different. These are the Kobe 8s, I believe, and got a hint of orange on them, some yellow, a little bit of blue, but the orange really making him pop, and he's not the only one with him. His teammates Marvin Witt and Ifeaki Ake with him as well. So definitely on the sneaker watch, as we're about a minute and 15 away from wrapping this up. We'll stay right here with you. Rattler fans, for all the action, all the coverage on St. Mary's Athletics, check out rattlerathletics.com. The Lady Rattlers are off to a terrific start. They'll be over in Tarleton State tomorrow, so be sure to check out the website for a report on that one. And of course, one last time, got to plug Tovar's Take. Check it out, a good read. Breaks down women's basketball's run, but also looks into the men's basketball team, this very team right here on the court, looking to make it not one, not two, but three consecutive Heartland Conference titles. As we approach the 1-minute mark, and the Rattlers here will play keep away from A&M Kingsville.
1 minute mark here in beautiful Bill Greehey Arena. 15 on the shot clock for St. Mary's.
Here is Benny over to Bauer. Benny gonna take the three, launches that shot, no good.
Good rebound there by the Javelinas. You can hear the St. Mary's coach yelling, no foul, no foul.
They gotta get that rebound, they don't. Oh, couple spills here. Diaz trying to stay with it.
Benny laying out there along with Diaz, who is on the floor. Ball still in the Javelinas' possession, the shot clock off. And it looks like some substitutions here. They're going to take out McDew, and Garcia will enter into the game. And a foul called there on Benny. And Bailey will head to the line for two free throws. Benny, only his first foul of the game. So very impressive from him. He's played extensive minutes, but still been able to play clean. Benny with 4 points in his first game in Bill Greehey Arena.
That free throw is no good by Bailey. And you're right, Benny, I was impressed with him. His athleticism really stuck out to me. It looked, at times, he was really poised to break out. But hey, the season's very, very young. And so.
Well, in your interview with him on Media Day, he said that his specialty was that he was a defensive player. He was a lockdown guy. And that really he likes setting his teammates up. So kind of a maestro out there on the floor. St. Mary's looking to run out the clock here. 15 seconds. The shot clock is turned off, and the foul going to be called there against Bailey.
What a high-scoring output by the Rattlers. 80 points they put up. That's been something the Rattlers don't usually do. They don't get to the 80s often.
Yes, indeed. And I think that the main thing that's different about the Rattler team this year than as compared to last year, a lot of shots earlier on in the shot clock as Thomas able to steal that one away. And Witt going to hold on to the ball. It's the final 5 seconds run out on the clock. And your St. Mary's Rattlers victorious in their first home effort. 80-65, the final score.
And that will do it from us inside Bill Greehey Arena. The Rattlers successful in their opening game here at home. Once again, the final score is 80-65. For Chad Peters, Robin Johnson, our broadcast colleague Brian McGlueon, Joe Rodriguez. Here's to another great basketball season together, my friend. I'm David Tovar. This has been a presentation of Rattler Athletics on the Rattler Network. Your men's basketball Rattlers successful 80-65 right here on Rattler Network.